The human brain, often considered the most sacred and treasured part of our body, gives us the power of free will. It's the very essence of who we are, and the idea of something else invading our minds, taking over and manipulating our thoughts and actions is nothing short of terrifying. We've seen this scenario play out in countless movies and shows, where it captures our imagination as a thrilling yet fictional concept. Except it isn't. Have you ever imagined a world where nature's most horrifying mind control tales weren't just fiction, but a haunting reality? Picture this. You get bitten by a seemingly harmless dog, and life goes on as usual. Until it doesn't. Months later, you start to notice something is horribly wrong. It is becoming difficult for you to swallow. You start producing more saliva, and with the weak control over your larynx, it becomes hard not to drool. You become incredibly thirsty, but the simple thought of water makes you shiver, and you reject all the glasses your partner tries to give you. You get anxious, then agitated, at sounds and touch. You have less and less control over your emotions and are overcome by an intense aggression. You stop talking. You just seethe, saliva frothing down your chin, eyes sunken from dehydration. The world is foreign to you now. When the compulsion for violence takes over your body, you lash out to the person closest to you. You bite them. Rabies virus. These minuscule creatures are incredibly tiny, several thousand times smaller than your average bacterium. In terms of genetic information, they carry less than 0.000001% of what we have in our genetic makeup. To put it in perspective, while our genes code for a whopping 100,000 proteins, the rabies virus gets by with just 5 proteins. Yet with these 5, they manage to cause one of the deadliest mind-controlling diseases we know of. The rabies virus travels along the nerves, but it can take a very long time before it reaches a nerve, which is why it can take weeks to months to see the clinical signs caused by this disease. When they reach the brain, the big behavioral changes start happening. They wreak havoc. It's a chaotic battlefield of destruction, but one with a precise and tactfully performed plan. The victim becomes fearful of water. Their salivary glands start overproducing. Their larynx becomes hard to control, making it challenging to swallow. In the meantime, the virus travels along the nerves to the salivary glands where it multiplies like there's no tomorrow. Now, here's where it gets truly bizarre. With this fear of water, excessive saliva, and the larynx acting up, the stage is set. The virus then triggers intense rage and violence, pushing the victim to bite. And with that bite, the rabies life cycle is complete. How on earth does the rabies virus manage to manipulate and change our behavior with just 5 proteins? Truth be told, we're still scratching our heads trying to figure that out. One thing's for sure though, if you ever find yourself bitten by an animal in a place that's not rabies-free, don't take any chances. Always make sure to get the rabies vaccination. But hold on, because rabies isn't the only creepy example out there. Allow me to introduce you to another mind-boggling parasite, the Lancet Fluke. This flatworm has a spine-chilling life cycle all of its own. The Lancet Fluke feels right at home in the cozy confines of a big cow liver, but getting there is a wild journey. It all begins when this clever parasite infects a snail. Inside the snail, it finds its way into the gooey slime that the snail leaves behind, just waiting for its next opportunity. And what's that opportunity, you ask? Well, it comes in the form of ants that have a taste for that slimy snack. The Lancet Fluke takes a ride inside these ants, further developing as it goes. But here's the twist. One of these flukes gets a special mission. It heads straight for a nerve center beneath the ant's brain and takes charge, like the captain of a ship. Now, most of the time, it just lounges around, biding its time. But when the object of its desire, a cow, strolls by, everything changes. This little fluke pulls off a dramatic stunt. It forces the ant to climb up a blade of grass, and then it paralyzes the ant, leaving it as easy pickings for the cow during its grazing. With this crafty maneuver, the Lancet Fluke has finally reached its destination. Now, let's delve into the world of a tiny protozoan parasite called Toxoplasma gondii, which unbeknownst to many, has a remarkable influence on our behavior.
Do we have a parasite in us? It's terrifying to think about, but apparently a third of the world's population is infected. So, listen up.
This crafty parasite primarily affects cats as their final host, but here's the twist. Almost any mammal or bird can serve as its intermediate host. Infected cats excrete the cysts of these parasites into the environment through their feces, where they can endure for years. When another creature ingests these cysts, the parasites take up residence in the brain, and its most well-documented effects are seen in mice. Ordinarily, mice possess a natural fear of the scent of cat urine, doing everything they can to steer clear of their feline predators. However, something extraordinary happens when mice are infected with Toxoplasma. Instead of fearing the scent, they're inexplicably drawn to it, following it right to its source. These mice, their once instinctive fear stripped away by the parasite, unwittingly become a quick meal for the cat, thus completing the Toxoplasma life cycle. In humans, Toxoplasma poses a danger to pregnant women and those with compromised immune systems. But for the average person, it doesn't manifest as an actual disease. While that's certainly a relief, here's the catch. Nearly one-third of the world's population carries this manipulative little parasite. Toxoplasma doesn't just coexist with us, it also tweaks our brain's fear circuits. This tweak has been associated with various behaviors in infected individuals, including heightened aggression, impulsiveness, road rage, and even suicide attempts. What's more, recent research suggests that Toxoplasma infection might serve as a surprising predictor of entrepreneurial activity. You heard that right. People infected with Toxoplasma are more inclined to start their own businesses. So, can microscopic organisms subtly alter our behavior, influencing us in ways we never suspected? With nearly one-third of the world's population under their sway, the question remains, could it be affecting you too? This is Nick the Veterinary Guy. Thank you for watching today's video, and of course make sure to like and subscribe if you want to see more stuff like this.